You guys are awesome. First of all, I want to say, fuck you, old man winter, for rolling in here and making it so cold. It kind of sucks. But I want to thank you guys for weathering the weather and just here to have a good time. Tell you what, I want to thank Scott Long, Mr. Bride Dog, Alex from the Gas Monkey, everybody that put this thing together. Everybody give them a big round of applause, man. I really, really appreciate it. Big love. Thank you so much. Birthdays are great, and I'm just happy to be here, and, you know, I got to tell you, thank you very much. One of my favorite bands in the world is Judas Priest, and I want to thank Judas Rising. They kicked some serious fucking ass. Let's hear it for them. I want to thank all my friends from Dallas, Texas, my hometown, and all my friends that came in from Vegas and Florida and everywhere else. Austin, we got Austin, Texas in the house, yeah! All right, and right now we are about to experience me and Dom's favorite band that we ever had in our entire life. That's right, get ready. Put your hands together for the Van Halen Experience! Yes! I'm
Yeah, baby.
Somebody.
touched you, but I can hide you, baby. Stand with this tonight. See now all my flavors are getting you satisfied. Hold on, hold on. Well, I'm usually passing by just about every block. Don't stop, I'm usually passing by. Well, every clock. Well, if you let me call you one time, you'd be more ready to stop. Okay, all right. Try to turn that you brought to me. And you other services too, you know. There's a back door to the state, you know what I mean? Oh,
Yeah.
I'm gonna make it. Thank you. gotta be for Mark.
There you go.
Mark.
Is that Jaeger?
Wish me luck, I've only played in Van Halen again. Thank you so much. And I can do something. Let's take a little trip down south of the border a ways, eh?
Thank you.
and shed a tear and said, just like any band, we're having a career difference here. We're having a musical difference, and we're going to go our own ways. And we cried and we hugged and we split. And 2 weeks later, I'm reading in Rolling Stone what an asshole I am, and how poor little Eddie was forced to spend the last 12 years of his life living a lie. That's the National Enquirer or something. And here comes his wife, you know, to back it up, you know, and on and on and on. So I stayed quiet for 6 months, 7 months. And I'm just reading diatribe after harangue, after this, after that, you know, again and again and again. And I still believe it's not necessary to make a comparison. I don't think you have to make a choice, but Van Halen demands it. Van Halen is demanding, for some bizarre, retarded reason, for the audience to make a choice. You have to either love us and hate him or vice versa. They demand it. Well, I'll rise to the challenge. If we have to have a comparison, then fine. I eat you for breakfast, pal. I eat you and smile.
Give me a bottle of anything and a glazed donut. To go.
Halen and its first outdoor date of its sold-out summer tour. This was in Boulder, Colorado. Yes, good morning.
Right, fine. Good morning, Brian. The new Van Halen is made up of brothers Eddie and Alex Van Halen, veteran Michael Anthony, and former solo star Sammy Hagar. Van Halen's album 5150 already sold 2.5 million copies thanks to its 3 top 10 hits, and it's convinced audiences that Sammy Hagar is more than a match for the departed David Lee Roth. The general public, who has been buying 5150 like hotcakes, didn't even blink at the change in the personnel in this band. In fact, the album soared. Did that surprise you?
Yeah, they didn't blink, did it.
Whoa, all right.
Sounded like this before.
Did it surprise you?
I just figured, if, you know, we make a good record and it sounds good, it doesn't matter who's playing. You know, actually, we didn't even play on the record.
We had the Marlins play.
It didn't surprise me. You know, we made this music. We've been hearing it all along. We were the first ones to hear it. And we were so excited every time we came up with a new song that it was like, when that record was done, we were so proud and so up for it. In my heart, I knew it was going to be extremely successful.
We figured if us four like something, it's about, you know, a few million other people out there are bound to like it too.
The spirit of this band that comes across now really does seem to be an all for one, one for all kind of happening. It seems like a very unified front. That's pretty accurate, isn't it?
It's much more a band than it used to be.
Do you guys spend any time reading or exercising? You know, what do you do with your time that you can talk about?
Well, as far as exercising, I think 2.5 hours on stage is probably more exercise than even Arnold Schwarzenegger can handle. As far as reading, sure, I read the set list every night.
I can't think of a band with higher visibility, with someone with a higher visibility than David leaving, with less of a brouhaha taking place after he left, where the fit was more exact. So, I mean, were you guys kind of ready for that, just to turn over that quickly?
I think we basically followed our heart. We knew that in our heart that this is going to be a great band, and we like to refer to it as the real Van Halen. As a matter of fact, Sammy was actually a choice of vocalist in 1977 when we signed with Warner Brothers.
You know, so the person left, didn't bother us any really, because Alex, Mike, and I have always been cool with Van Halen anyway. You know,
it was easy to see that when I came in. As soon as I heard these guys playing music, the sound had so much identity. It sounded exactly like Van Halen without a singer. And I went, whoa. You know, it's like it dawns on you. You don't ever think of it like that, you know. But these guys did play all the instruments and nothing changed. All the music came from there. And it's so much Van Halen that it was like, for me, I just went, well, this is great. I just walked in here being myself.
Van Halen has a reputation for partying hard on the road, and tomorrow in part two of our interview, we'll talk to them about life on the road, their marriages, groupies, and what it's really like to be rock and roll stars.
Thank you.
Sugar and spice and everything nice. That's what little girls are made.